Sonic Restaurant for the NES, a game that many people have talked about and would love to have in their collection. Some say this game is very rare, one of the most rare of all time, but you know what? It's actually not, as that would probably go to Stadium Events, Myriad, 6-in-1, Peekaboo Poker, Cheat-em-un 2, and of course Action 52, on top of, let's say, Nintendo World Championship 1990. RarityGuide.com has the game at 82% rare, so it's not the most rare game of all time. If people say that, they're full of bullshit. Panic Restaurant was developed by EIM and published by Taito. It was released in 1992, originally in Japan and North America, but was released 2 years later in 1994 over in Europe. As you can see, Panic Restaurant is a 2D side-scrolling platformer where you play as a chef named Cookie, and you will go through your own restaurant, which has been cursed by Odove. There are 6 levels you will go through, and they are kitchen, freezer, basement, and more, as you will be battling through food monsters and using kitchen utensils as weapons. Some of the enemies are pizzas, sausage, burgers, onions, microwaves, and so on, which is pretty funny. One of the weapons is a frying pan that you can bash the shit out of your enemies with, and the second weapon that I've seen is a plastic-like spoon. At the end of each level, you will face a boss, which is pretty typical in a 2D platformer around this time, and in between each level, there is a bonus game where you can play a slot machine to win extra health and lives, which will help you out a lot. The game is very simple, and while the story isn't mind-blowing and really in-depth, it's actually pretty cool. Now, the game was created by Kenji Inoue, who is best known for the D games, which are puzzle horror games that were on, I think, the PlayStation, PC, Sega Saturn, and I think the sequel, D2, was on the Sega Dreamcast. When it comes to EIM, they are a short-lived Japanese game development studio that was founded by Inoue in 1989, and they released Time Zone, Panic Restaurant, as well as Parallel World. They also did the sound programming and music for Casino Kid 2. Now, you're probably wondering if Panic Restaurant is a difficult game. It's not balls-to-the-wall tough, at least early in the game, but it does have moments that might be a little bit on the tough side. And really, it has something to do with the controls more than anything, so I'll talk about that here shortly. Now, the graphics for Panic Restaurant are good, but there are some issues. First of all, the design of the main character, Cookie, is nice. The level designs are great, the enemies are cool, and the game is colorful. One thing I noticed, though, a lot of flickering and some slowdown. Nothing too drastic, but it's enough to be a flaw as far as I'm concerned. It's mostly the flickering that really annoys the shit out of me. And of course, even though the NES can do a lot, some developers had a hell of a time with development, and there was a lot of flickering in their games. While I understand why these games are like this on the NES, it's still a flaw to me, but it's a very small flaw. It's nothing that's game-breaking or anything else. The music? I love it, ranging from the level music, boss battle music, and even the music during the bonus games. It's well-composed, fits this type of game, sounds like a lot of effort went into it. Same with the sound effects, they're good as well. Nothing to complain about here. The controls? Well, they are good. Moving around is easy, jumping and attacking is easy. My only problem is the character moves slow, and you can't go any faster. That can be frustrating in some instances. Once again, is this a huge flaw? No, I could work around this. But I just wish Cookie would move a lot faster than he does. With that being said, when it comes to responding, when you hit the buttons and you move and all that type of shit, they do respond pretty damn good. Panic Restaurant is a fun game. A little tough in some spots and a few flaws here and there, but nothing major. The game is a blast to play. I do wish there was a few more levels, but 6 isn't bad. The gameplay is fun, the graphics are good when it comes to sprite design on Cookie and the enemies and so on, as well as the level design, but it does have some flickering issues. The music is badass, the sound effects are nice, and while the controls when it comes to layout and of course being responsive are good, the movement of the character is slow. Either way, the game has minor flaws to it and is still a blast to play. If you like action slash platformer games, you will enjoy Panic Restaurant a lot. Like I mentioned earlier, Panic Restaurant is 82% rare. Prices on eBay, well, let's just say this. Emulate the fucking game. Prices are really high, and they are $559, $650, $560. You can find some repro carts out there for around $39, $29, $30, and so on. Another legit copy for $539. A mint condition graded version for $2,229. But wait, there's more. For a rare prototype cartridge, $10,000 on eBay. That's fucked. I understand prototype cartridges are rare, but if there's no fucking way that I'm going to take $10,000 and buy a fucking prototype cartridge. If you want a repro cart, that isn't too bad, but don't go for the original. The prices are bullshit stupid. Sadly, there is no sequel. It was just a one-and-done game. I think if this game continued on with some sequels on the Super Nintendo, and maybe the Nintendo 64, that would have been really cool. I hope you enjoyed this review of Panic Restaurant for the NES. Thanks for watching.